That young man right there, the nephew of Scottie Pippen, of course, one of the top 50 players the last half of last century, has a motor. Banged up his shoulder the other night. Let's see if he comes out on fire, and he does. He hurt his shoulder in the win over Houston Baptist. He's got as much range as anybody in college basketball when he's hot.
Yeah, when he's hot, he's hot. He'll take that three-point jump shot.
Tried to go inside of Criddle, and Pippen poked it away. Pippen's given up a lot of size to Criddle, but he's awfully tenacious on defense. A little shot fake and drive from Barnes, and he missed fires, and Pippen the rebound.
A great inside position by rebound by Pippen, doing a great job.
Quinn Pippen is starting for Chicago State here in the second half, despite those three fouls. You're down by 16 at the break. You can't save him.
No, he had to come in and play.
Down low to Criddle. Little turnaround jumpers up, and he missed one. Pippen the rebound. Chicago State trying to win in a very tough place to play, and there's Pippen now, 2 for 2.
So now, do you get a ball to Pippen? Let him try for another three?
I think you have to.
He hit his last one. Why not?
He's posting up now. Almost a steal out front by Daniel Barnes.
He was wide open, too.
Little step back for Pippen.
That's going to be a two.
Quinton Pippen feeling it tonight.
Well, he was wide open, and then he came off of a screen.
Two Cougar players ran into each other, and that almost gave a odd man break for UIC. In fact, they had one, just didn't take advantage of it. Here's Barnes looking for a fifth three, halfway down. 11-point game. Chicago State looks to add to it. Chicago State with the basketball. Dishmukes to Pippen. Finds a seam. Strip. Talton thought he had all ball.
Oh, what a hole. You know, we think so much of Pippen just shooting, but he saw a hole that you could drive a Mack truck through, and I think he was even surprised. I mean, he was surprised. He's a three-point shooter.
Uh-huh.
And he saw that hole. He was like, whoa.
Pippen at the free throw line to tie the basketball game. Pippen this year, 78% from the stripe. This will be his first free throw of the night. This is a very good free throw shooting team, Chicago State.
Did you notice the way he took his time? They see some Chicago State fans.
This team is 50th best in the nation, shooting 73% as a team. And Pippen has tied the game.
Unbelievable.
The 20-point lead for UIC is gone. And the Chicago State faithful here at the pavilion on their feet. Talton on the wing to Barnes. Ross controls.
You slow down. You slow down. You take your time. You get a good shot. You don't want to come down and take a bad shot.
Dishmukes back door. Pippen, the Cougars lead.
Oh, Corey Gray almost lost control of the basketball, but he saw Pippen. He was able to get it to him.
6-point lead for UIC trying to advance in the CIT and get their first ever tournament victory. Pippen against Brown to Ross, looking for his seventh three of the night. That was no good.
Well, that's a good play, though.
And a good pass by Pippen. You know he wanted to try to take his man.
Can't say enough about the job he's done.
And UIC less than 2 minutes away from their first ever postseason win. So both ways tonight looks like going to be history made for two Chicago teams, two state schools.
Boy, look at the Cougars diving all over the floor. An A for effort by Chicago State. They tied the game up at 61, but since that point, it has been all UIC. Nobody guarding the basket.
Well, there you saw the athleticism of Pippen. He made up about 10 feet on Miller. Wasn't able to hang on, though.
This is what DePaul, what they want to do. They want to get down quickly.
An easy shot was missed by McKinney, and the rebound is controlled by Chicago State. That was Pippen controlling the glass at 6'4".
Very good sportsmanship by Chicago State.
Here's Pippen. Left-hander pulls up for 17 and buries it. Trying to go down, low ball poked away by Ross. That's about the third steal for Ross so far.
Yeah, very active hands on the defensive end by Ross.
Pippen for three. How many times have you heard that said in Chicago over the years?
By the same number. Chicago State, the Cougars get this basketball. Take your time. Don't make this a track meet.
Kenny, I love this tempo for him. You're right.
Yeah, so you don't want to make this a track meet.
Pippen will try again.
Why
and
not?
Hit again.
Well,
Uncle Scotty, be happy.
And they got to call a timeout by the Blue Demons. I always say you dance with the lady you brought to the disco. So he's the one that brought you there. You give it right back to him. He hits it again.
Tucker thought about a three. Surprised Pippen didn't take it. Tucker will.
Catch and shoot.
People would have paid big bucks to get in to watch those guys play. There goes Pippen down the lane.
Nice move by Pippen. A little shake and bake.
Williams to
you
Tucker.
You know what? You just run this down. I don't even care if you don't get a shot off.
Tucker around a screen in the corner. Too Pippen soon. For three. Got it. He's got three of those here in the first half. Tucker a three. That's off the mark. Rebound falls into the hands of Pippen. And he's fouled. We'll go to the line. Foul will be called on Donovan Kirk.
So now you have to make your free throws. Your free throws are crucial.
So far tonight, the Cougars are 6 of 10 from the line. Look at the discrepancy in free throws. 23 attempts for DePaul, 10 attempts for Chicago State.
Well, that says to me that if you take a good look at Tracy Beauty, you have to attack the basket if you're the Chicago State Cougars.
Well, that was the difference between what Pippen did that time and what some of the guards have been doing. Pippen went in there strong instead of a little fadeaway flip shot. Big difference.
Yeah, without question. You want to go strong with the basketball.
Pippen to tie the game at 58. Straight up 6 minutes to play, and he does.